Now we would like to welcome you to our science demonstration this Sabbath morning. And if you were with us last Sabbath and maybe saw what we posted Sunday or Monday, you know that I promised you something to do with beans. And I had this full package of 15 beans, and it was all about when we become Christians, what happens to us? Now, in this 15 bean soup are 15 different kinds of beans, and I am now going to move over to the tray and pour out some of these beans for you to see. And Ashley, you can come help me sort them if you would like, because I would like to see how many we can find. There's a lima bean, a garbanzo,
some peas,
some lentils, kidney beans.
Lima beans?
Yes.
Pintos. Black beans.
Navy beans. I found a navy bean. Anything else in this group? I know there are cranberry beans. Yes, we got the limas, and that's a cranberry bean. This is a red bean. It's not quite. Anything else? All right, let's hope things are coming through. We're getting a phone call. And some of these are split peas, split greens, and split yellow peas. Now, we are going to do a demonstration that uses all of these beans. And I'm going to put them in our glass here. But can you think, Ashley, how if these were all Christians, what kinds of different Christians could there be that would represent each of these cranberries and pintos and red and kidneys? And any thoughts about how this could represent our brothers and sisters in Christ? Well, one could be a boy, one could be a girl, one could be rich, one could be poor, one could be in school, one could be out of school, a student, you know, all different kinds. These beans can represent different kinds of Christians. But these split peas, they're not a whole lagoon, because it's a whole pea is round and a split pea has been cut in half. So and these yellow split peas, we could call them maybe half Christians, or one foot in the world and one foot in Christ. And I'm not sure if they will germinate at all. But Ashley, if you could help.
Here.
Okay, we're going to, what we did for our demonstration is that we used these beans in equal amounts with sand. She's going to try to scoop this up. That's all right if we lose a few. And pour it into our hands. Thank you very much. Now these beans are, okay, go ahead. These beans are dry beans. That means they could be kept in storage for a long time. However, when water comes in contact with them, something happens. And in order to show what happens in our experiment, we used sand. We used equal amounts of beans and sand. And you kind of mix it together. And let's see, I'll use this jar to scoop some sand up out of here. And we put it in here, and we stirred it all up. And then we poured water. Well, we make this. Make sure we have equal amounts, and it has to fill our jar. So I'm going to pour this into our jar. This is what we did at home, because we had to do this ahead of time for it to work. And I don't have quite enough to fill this jar. But you can see the beans are in there, the sand is in there. And at home, we filled it all the way up, as much as we could get in there. And we shook it down and put more in, kept shaking and put more in. And then when it was filled, we trickled water in there so that the water went all the way down and wet all the sand. And after we had it wet and it was full, then we put our cap on tightly. And that's all we did. And then we just set it aside on a tray like that and waited. Now, while we're kind of waiting too, let's go to slide number 2 of our demonstration presentation. And it's based on 2 Corinthians 5:17. Would you like to read it for us, Ashley, please?
Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new.
Right. 2 Corinthians 5:17. So that means when we come to Christ and we surrender our lives to Christ, all things are gone and we're new. And these beings that are dry and just sitting around become new with the word of Christ in our, living in us. And next slide, slide 3, shows somebody who's going to sprout these legumes. All different kinds of beans are soaking there on slide 3. That's October 26. Slide 4, by October 31, they are beginning to sprout. And if at home, if your mother or if you have ever sprouted alfalfa seeds or different kinds of seeds, you know what happens. They begin to grow. They're not the old dead beans or seeds that they used to be. This is slide 4 shows October 31. By November 3, they're ready to put in a salad. And that's what slide 5 shows us. Yummy sprouts that can be eaten. There is no stopping a sprout once it's gotten moisture. You can't stop it from growing unless you tear it apart or something. But if you leave it alone, it will grow. And that reminds me of a story I read by a scientist who put this particular experiment together, that during World War II, a supply ship had been slightly torpedoed. But it was okay. It didn't sink the ship. The ship could continue on to its port. But what it was carrying was food. And the food it was carrying were dried beans. And so when the torpedo breached the hull of that ship, moisture got in. Not enough to sink the ship, but enough to wet the beans. And they started to grow. And they kept growing. And this was a whole ship full of beans. That's what was in the, the part of the ship that carried the supplies.
The hull.
Were beans, dried beans, taking it to another place. However, once the moisture got in, things changed. Old things were passed away, and the beans became new creatures, so to speak. And do you know what? Before that ship could reach port, the beans had swelled so much and had grown so much that it cracked the hull of that ship. And then the ship sank. So let's move on. Whoops, got to go back, sorry, to our next slide. Slide 6 tells you the items you need for this demonstration. Just some dried seeds of beans, peas, corn, limas, whatever, some sand, some water, and a clear container that can be sealed. And this is a little fruit preserve container. It's just about the right size. You could use a quart jar, but you would need a lot of beans and a lot of sand. Or you could use a plastic pill bottle, just something with a screw-on lid. Next slide procedure. You mix the seeds and sand in equal amounts, pour it into a jar, shaking the jar to fill it completely, wet the sand thoroughly, and then screw the lid on tightly. If glass is used, put the jar on a cookie sheet to prevent a spill, because something's going to happen, just like to that ship. And then you have to wait. It could be 8 hours. It could be 48 hours. It all depends on the circumstances. We did 3 different experiments, and time was different, I think, for all of them. Next slide, 8. The seed, now this tells you why this bean, this dry bean, changes when it comes in contact with moisture. The seed coat has a small opening. And let's see if I can find.
You can see it in the lima bean.
Okay. Or here, in a curved bean. I'm sorry. A curved bean, up here higher?
Right there.
Okay. A curved bean often has, on the indented side, that's the side where the opening is, and it admits water. The inner embryo or germ of the seed readily absorbs the water, swelling in the process and cracking the outer shell. It will then produce a root and a stem. And the pressure exerted by a growing seed or plant is tremendous. Perhaps you've seen a plant gradually overturn a rock or raise a slab of concrete. Next slide, 9.
I've seen plants go through asphalt on the...
Through asphalt, too. Okay, slide 9 shows an acorn that has germinated, and you can see the outside shell has cracked. Slide 10 shows you a tree. And this growing tree, we know trees are strong, but the root system has lifted up that sidewalk. And then slide 11 and 12 tell you about what I just told you, about the ship that sunk because the seeds, the beans in its hull, were moistened and started to grow, and pressure pushed out and broke the hull of that ship. Now here's what has happened. I'm on slide 13. What has happened in our demonstration? First try, we filled up our fruit preserve jar, and you can see the sand and the seeds. And when you're shaking it down, the seeds kind of go in the middle, and you mainly just see the sand, but it's equal amounts. First try, slide 15, after 8 hours, there's our jar, exploded. The pressure inside there breaks glass. Next slide, 16, the second try, we used a different kind of fruit preserve jar. And we waited. Slide 17. The close-up. Has that broken yet in that close-up? No. This is the bottom of that jar of our second try. And the reason we have the close-up there is because in the next slide, 18, after 8 hours, the bottom of that jar, that must have been where it was weak, cracked open.
That's where the
beans were. The beans were down there too. That's true. We tried it again. We wanted, you know why? Pastor really wanted you to be able to see this jar explode. So we had a camera on it hour after hour. And we missed the second try. So we tried again on our third try, slide 19, another fruit preserve jar. And after a few hours, it didn't take 8 hours this time, the jar cracked. You can see that. Another view in slide 21, the back view of this cracked jar because of the pressure. And then after time, it continued to grow and fell on its side. And this is what our third try looked like after we waited even more time. In the classroom, I'm ready to show you what's going to happen. Now the application in slide 24. These growing seeds represent a new Christian. Exciting changes occur when you give your life to Jesus. Your growth cannot be contained. And you know, I like the 15 bean soup because all of us are different. None of us are the same. But we all grow under the watering of God's Spirit and heavenly influences in our lives, and through the Word of God, we're all growing, whether we're little and big, young and old, rich or poor, educated or not educated. It doesn't matter what kind of being you are. You will grow under the Spirit of God if you surrender your life to Him now. The split peas and the did not grow. They cannot grow because they're split. They're like half. They're a half Christian. No half Christian will grow, but a whole Christian will if you surrender your lives to God. Now, we're going to move on.
And also on the inside of the seed, if you break the seed open, you will see the little plant where once it gets moist, that's where it germinates.
And you've done that?
Yeah, I've broken open seeds, and you can see, like, I think it's like a little embryo.
And it's, and there is in every seed, there's an opening where the moisture can seep in, and that's what starts the growth. And we want you to join us again next Sabbath. Thank you for being here this Sabbath. And we're just very thankful that you have decided to surrender your life to Jesus. Awesome.